嗨，大家好，欢迎来到网易公开课 A Talk 英语访谈，我是主持人饶顺。今天我们很荣幸邀请到了欧盟电影节的开幕式电影 Easing 的导演 Andrea Magnani 先生。Hi, Mr. Andrea Magnani. Welcome to A Talk. Welcome to Nelly's.
Thank you to you. Thank you for your welcoming. Yeah.
Thank you. It's a real pleasure to have you on the show. How are you today?
As I told you before, yes, I'm quite excited because I'm supposed to be tired, but actually, because I'm happy maybe to be here. And so,
your film will be shown here, right?
Yeah. So it will be screened in a few, less than an hour, I think. So I'm very excited to see how the audience will get the movie.
Me too. I'll be in the audience also watch your movies. But in the beginning, could you please first say hi to your audience?
Oh, of course, sorry, I just say hi to you, but of course, hi to all the audience of A Talk that
is there.
I hope you can enjoy through our talk what is talking about.
Yeah, definitely. Could you please tell us a bit more about the movie? Why it's called Easy?
Well, it's quite interesting because maybe just an Italian can understand that. Because easy, it means easy in English.
Yeah,
but also the same pronunciation in Italy, in Italian, it's also the diminutive of Isidoro.
Isidoro.
It's a given name, it's a first name, Isidoro. It's the main character given name, Isidoro. But everybody calls him with a diminutive, with the nickname that is easy.And at the same time, easy has the same spelling of easy in English.
Yeah.
And I thought was a perfect match because for this character, this journey is not easy at all. And so in order to make a contradiction of it, yeah.
I see. It's also a poem, right? Yeah, a poem. It has two meanings.
Yeah, exactly.
Great. Can you tell us more about the plot? What's the movie about?
Well, the movie is telling a story of a road movie.Is a journey between through half Europe, between Italy and Ukraine, and it's a journey that makes Isidoro that has to carry in a coffin from a former bricklayer that died in a building under construction, and he comes from Ukraine. He was Ukrainian, and Izzy has to carry the body.In the coffin from Italy to Ukraine, and he has to do it because his younger brother, Izzy's younger brother, asked him to do it in order to solve some dirty problems the brother had with his death.
I see, dirty problems. Okay.
Dirty problems. Yeah, because he died. Actually, the Ukrainian bricklayer died in a building under construction that is owned by Izzy's brother. So having that body.Outside the country, fast as possible. This is the
helping escape away from the crime, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
I see. And also, I saw the trailer. It's really interesting. It's obviously a comedy, right?
Well, yeah. I'd say that Izzy is running on the thin line between comedy on one side and on the other side, the most some melancholic moments, poetic moments. Mm-hmm. So it's like a bittersweet comedy.
Bittersweet
comedy or a dramedy, as in Europe they like to call it now dramedy, but I think it's...
Yeah, I love that term.
I don't know if it's nice, but I think what I prefer is to be on the edge between comedy and something more deep and reflexive.
Yeah, and also notice that the main character is a bit on the overweight side.
Overweight, you mean?
Yeah. But it seems that when he was little, when he was young, he was not that fat, right?
Not exactly.
Some accident or incident happened to him that made him
the main problem he had, the character, was to get depressed. Get depressed meant to stop his career as a car racer because he was a very talented young car racer. And the depression stopped him.
I see.
And also, depression sometimes comes also with food disorders.
Yeah, it's common. Some people, when they're sad, depressed, they keep eating.
Exactly, and then you start gaining weight. Mm-hmm. And now when the movie starts, we find Izzy like he is. I mean, overweight, depressed, and without any purpose in life.
I see. So it could be like a trip, a journey to help him find meaning in life. Easy will be able to find his life back or his meaning in life during the whole journey.
I mean, I don't believe in movies that in 4 days, 5 days of narration could save the character or solve all the problems. I mean, so probably Easy at the end doesn't solve his depression problems, but he has the key. The key to start again and maybe to solve his problems and to start a new life.
Mm-hmm.
So this was my main address. On the movie. I think we have inside us all what we need in order to succeed, in order to move on. But simply,
even though you're over obese,
we don't know them yet. So maybe the journey, actually, journey is always good, because journey is a change.
Yep.
When you change environment, when you change people around you, I think it's better, it's good.
You will discover something new.
New about
new
you.
About yourself.
Exactly.
Very good. So that can I say that's also something you hope the audience will be able to take away from the movie after watching it?
I hope so. But for example, one of the things people, audience told me all the time is, They start, because movie is ending with Easy on a certain point, and I cannot tell you now because
you have to go watch the movie. Yeah, we don't want to spoil.
Some people of the audience say, you know, I was thinking about how it happens to Easy after the end of the movie. So how the journey begins again or continue or he gets back. So the audience starts thinking about
what's going to happen to him
in a way is also what is going to happen to us.
Relate the journey, the experience to us, right?
Yeah, I hope that like for the audience that ask what happened then to Easy, maybe they discover something about themselves and who knows, maybe they can help them. I mean, especially people that feel a little bit abandoned by life, a little bit lost.
Yeah.
Maybe my hope is that watching a movie that tells a story about hopes, I think
it's a silver lining.
Yeah. Yeah.
good. So I kind of can sense there might be a sequel of the movie. Easy 2.
Easy 2. No, I don't believe in sequels.
You don't believe in sequels? Why?
I believe more in a spin-off or something like that, you know. And if I see an Easy, I can see maybe in a TV series the sequel, not in a movie. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just to cross different kind of
stories, characters.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
But to me the journey of Easy is completed with this movie.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think there's a need of a sequel.
Mm-hmm.
But if you ask me, I can do it, no problem. just for you.
Oh, thank you. I'm really honored. Can you also share your experience with us? How in the first place, what made you want to shoot such a movie? What inspired you or motivated you to shoot the movie?
Well, actually, I had this picture in my mind about a man carrying a coffin. And this is because I think, because I'm obsessed with death. In last 10 years or maybe more, I'm quite obsessed about this. How can I say, everyone has to face it before or later.
Oh yeah, sooner or later we all.
And you know, I think this is a very taboo of our lives.
Yeah.
I mean, we don't want to talk it about, you know, about it. I think we also invented religion sometimes to accept it.
Yep.
And so I had this image, this picture on my mind, but at the same time I didn't have any character. If you don't have any character, you don't have any story.
Yeah.
And then was when I faced friends of mine that was depressed and falling into depression, and I thought was the perfect match. I mean, as I said also before, I think that a depressed man is also a dead man inside. And I think that dead man inside that carries a dead body, in order to have his life back could be the perfect character to make this journey. And when I discovered the character, the story came by itself. I mean, so it was very easy.
Great. You're also the writer of movie scripts.
I'm the writer and the director, yes.
Great.
È una cosa facilissima, sono un paio di giorni. Devi solo guidare.
Non posso lavorare, sono diagnosticamente depresso.
Tu non sei depresso, tu sei tossico, che è diverso. C'è stato un incidente al cantiere. I suoi colleghi hanno fatto una colletta per portare la salma in Ucraina, al confine con l'Ungheria.
Sei sicuro che è l'uomo giusto per questa cosa?
A 14 anni è diventato campione italiano di go-kart. A 17 anni si parlava di lui in ambiente di Formula 1.
Perché non parte?
Perché non parte?
Easy.
Vai. Arriverete a destinazione tra 911 km. Fuori percorso. Ricalcolo. Ricalcolo. Ah!
Felicità.
E il tuo sguardo innocente in mezzo alla gente, la felicità.
Senti, nell'area c'è già la nostra.
Un momento.
Tutto a posto, c'è tutto?
Uno sentimento.
Non so dove sto.
Uno complimento. Sacramento.
La barba in questa foto, vedi?
Welcome to Ukraine.
Really impressed by that. And I also saw your profile on IMDb. I can't help but note, is this your first feature film?
Exactly, yes, my first feature film. Because I'm not the youngest director in Italy, because I mean...
you look young.
Yeah, this is my first feature film, but before I was working as a screenwriter. As a writer, and mainly for TV fictions.
I see. So it must be totally different, right? Writing TV scripts, movie scripts, and directing a movie.
I was just writing TV series, and
now you're directing a movie.
I'm directing a movie, and I think I was writing a movie like that, like Easy, that is very. There are no many dialogues in the movie.
Uh-huh.
And despite it's a comedy, because I like comedies made by situations and not by dialogues.
Yeah, that's
and I
good,
think
that's
this was a reaction also to my past of a screenwriter in TV, where dialogues were everything, you know?
Yeah.
So on TV, you put dialogues everywhere in order to tell everything.
Yeah, but dialogues had its own, we call that shortages, because of translation, also the cultural difference, some like, sense of humor is maybe missing in certain
in a
different country, right?
What I wanted is that, I mean, that kind of work on television was very frustrating to me, because everything was dialogue and I didn't want to do that. So Easy is a proof of it. So maybe I did Easy to prove to myself that I can also write with less dialogues, more situation, more
body languages,
exactly,
to amuse
exactly
the audience, right? Very good. So I'm sure directing a movie, there are many aspects you need to really consider. It's a tough job. Well, so what aspect do you think is, in your opinion, is the most difficult thing when directing a movie?
Well, you know, director sometimes is also like the directors of orchestras, they need to understand everybody and to lead everybody to the final goal.
Yeah,
and this is quite this is something that I learned on the set. I mean, that you are in charge.
Yeah,
and you cannot delegate at the end. You are in charge, and you need to prove to everybody that you are in charge, and you need to put and you need to carry on the movie till the end.
Yeah, you make all the important decisions.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. And then what it's very important, it's to have clear ideas of what you want to do. Mm-hmm. This is the main aspect of the direction that I learned. Mm-hmm. If you have a very clear idea, even if it's simple, but mm-hmm. you have a clear idea of what you want to do, then everything is simple. Simple in any other aspect, in cinematography, in the direction of the actors, you know. But you have to
clear
know,
picture, clear idea,
clear picture, idea
stick
of,
to that.
And stick to that. Mm-hmm. Because also other people in the crew are following you. Mm-hmm. And if they feel that you don't have a clear idea of what you're doing, they
get
lost.
Yeah. Very good. Wow. Thank you for sharing that with us. My next question maybe related to China. Right now you're in China, right? How much do you know about Chinese movies?
Well, what in Italy and in Europe came from China. So, you know, especially in the 80s and the 90s,
Zhang Yimou,
was very famous in the 80s and 90s in Europe and in Italy. So I saw almost all of them.
Wow.
And then other movies that were coming from together with other with other Chinese authors. Mm-hmm. Also some Hong Kong movies,
like
Ang Lee or
Ang Lee,
John Woo. Yeah, and we had the impression, I mean, I had the impression in Italy that was very, very different the way of these two cinemas in a way, no? The authorial one from authorial, the art house one from
Zhang Yimou. Yep.
And the Ang Lee or John Woo that was more action or were most genre movie.
Yep.
And I thought, how can it be possible in the same country to do that? And then actually, I mean, it's simple because you have to follow just your dreams, and maybe you can have both cinemas in one country. No, I'm telling this because it's very difficult to understand for an Italian.
Really?
In,
why?
Yes, because in Italy we are stuck
with
in art house movies, so we don't do almost never genre movies.
Oh.
No actions, no horrors, no thrillers. And
art movie, do you mean like indie movies like that?
So yeah. We are stuck on that, and we cannot believe when one other country can do any kind of movies like China, like France, like America, I mean, like United States. So I don't know if I think it was cinema, Chinese cinema, that put me this idea to come here before or later, because I think it's one of the countries that I always wanted to visit, and it's a pity to be here just for one day and a half in Beijing.
Oh, that's but way
I
not
hope
enough.
I hope this is just my first time, you know, and then many other will follow, I hope that.
Yeah. We would love to see more of the Western movies and also Western movie elements come to China. And we see many co-cooperation between the Chinese movie makers and the Western movie makers. Yeah, it's quite trendy now.
So, I always thought about my idea of cinema to be a cinema that helps me to travel along the world and not in the matter of a tourist wise, but just to discover more about the people that are living in this world, you know.
Yeah.
And to me, cinema is that. I mean, also easy is a way to discover another culture, another country, another people, and I would dream to have the opportunity to make films again that are discovering, from my point of view, other countries, and
great.
China would be the first one on the top list.
Great. Good to hear that. Hopefully in the future there'll be another like easy kind of movie.
I think
a journey to China.
Yeah.
A task given to easy again.
Exactly.
we
have a story here. Yeah.
Great. Easy too. Excellent. So before we finish up here, do you have any other words you'd like to say to Chinese audience?
That you have maybe the opportunity to see Easy. I would like to understand what you think about it. So write me. If you see the movie, if you watch the movie, write me on Facebook. I will answer to all of you. I promise. So keep in touch. this is my hope.
Thank you so much for
thank you to you.
Thank you so much for taking the interview.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Bye bye.
Take care. Bye bye.